I am Professor Dr. Jadhav J.S. from HGM College, Karad. In today's lecture, we will see the first unit, Relational Database Management System. In that, we see what is meaning of Relational Database Management System, the definition of RDBMS. RDBMS is nothing but Relational Database Management System. It is acronym of Relational Database Management System. The definition of Relational Database Management System is it provides comprehensive, integrated and relative approach of data management. Let's see the meaning of comprehensive, relative and integrated. What is meaning of comprehensive? Comprehensive means all type of data can store in single database. All type of data means the data may be number format, data may be character format A to Z, or data may be in string format, or whether it may be fractional format. All kind of data can store in single database system. The relative concept means the data are related and this related data can store in single database. Data must be connected with each other. And what is meaning of integrated? Integrated means the data are joined separately within that database. Thus, by using RDBMS concept, we can manipulate data or we can manage data by the data may be comprehensive, relative and integrated. This RDBMS is simple technology or a simple technique of managing data by using relations. These relations are nothing but relational model. Means in RDBMS we can manage data or we can store data by using relational model. What is meaning of relational model? Relational model is used again in computer science subject through RDBMS. Relations are grid-like mathematical concept or structure which having intersection of rows and columns. Relational models are nothing but relations. All data are logically stored within that relational model or relations. Simply, relations having two meaning. First meaning is relations is nothing but table. And that table are connected table with each other. That means data of one table connected with data of another table. That means two tables are connected with each other. Next point we see here, the basic concept of Relational Database Management System. By using these three points, we can manage our data in database management system. The first point is structure. That means, what is meaning of structure? Structure are consist of collection of different objects or different relations that store our data within that database. In simple language, the structure means table. Structure is nothing but table or our relation which store our data in that database. The second concept is operator. Operators are nothing but the signs and symbols. That signs and symbols are used to manipulate or to handle our data in database. The third concept is integrity constraint. Integrity constraint, what is meaning of constraint? Constraint means the rules. Integrity constraint also having meaning the rules or laws or protocols. By using these some rules or laws, we can store our data within the table. Each and every time integrity constraint are used with operators and we can store our data in specific structure that is called as table in Relational Database Management System. The next concept next point is the different components of relational database management system. There are six components. What is meaning of component? Component means parts. By using these parts, we can store our data in database management system. The first part of the first component is table. Table is simple basic structure. In this simple basic structure, the data is stored within intersection of rows and column, and the table represents entity. For example, we have department table. In department table, we store all information related only department. For example, department number, department name is row. Row is nothing but horizontal arrangement of data item within the table. Row is nothing but combination of different column values of that particular table. Row is also called as records, and record is also called as row. The next component is column. What is meaning of column? Column is vertical arrangement of particular data item. That data items are only same data type. Column is also called as attribute, and attribute is also called as column. The next component is field. Field is nothing but intersection of rows and column. It contains only data values, for example, characters, numbers, fractional points, strings, or any other symbols. Only single data value we can store in one field. If there is no any data value stored in that particular field, that field is called as null value. I hope you all understand the different components. The fifth component is primary key. Primary key is used to identify uniquely record in each row. This primary key is given only to column in a particular table. It consists of particular value, and that value does not repeated, or that value does not duplicated in that particular table. For example, in our department table, we have department number attribute, and if that department number attribute we have given the primary key, then then each and every time different department numbers are stored in department table. Single data value of department number cannot store in that department table. The last component is foreign key. Foreign key is nothing but reference key. It reference of primary key of one table to another table. This foreign key is given to only for column, for it creates connection between two tables. That means data of one table can be connected to data of another table. All these diagrams are diagrammatical representation of theoretical concept of components or parts of relational database management system. This is the basic structure called as table. Here we can store our data in database. And this vertical arrangement in a table is called as column. It stores only single data type value. This is called as row. It is horizontal arrangement of